and sports, members of the Board of Governors, distinguished guests, Dr. George Ford, principal of this prestigious institution, faculty and staff of the college, my fellow graduates, I bid you all a pleasant evening. At this moment, hundreds of beautiful babies are entering this world. May their lives be prosperous. Hundreds of souls are crossing the horizon of death. May they rest in peace. This very second, a cosmic explosion races across a distant galaxy, vaporizing everything in its path for millions of miles. But at this moment, my fellow graduates of 2005, in our individual states of consciousness, we are the center of the universe. Nothing else matters. This moment is ours. Just as this morning once was the scene of many battles for control of this our island, through survival, it remains a war zone for intellectual development and progress. This is our march of victory. Calculation, strategy, and the grace of the Almighty have brought us here. To paraphrase the words of the great Captain Morpheus in The Matrix Reloaded. Tonight is not an accident. There are no accidents. We have not come here by chance. I do not believe in chance. When I see you, luminous graduates, distinguished guests, proud parents and lecturers, I do not see coincidence. I see providence. I see purpose. The complexity of individuality bears a unique burden, my colleagues. Let me commence this address with a description of this college which may seem like biblical truth to you, yet simultaneously a bullet and lie to you. But to you, my fellow graduate, SALCC is a radiant castle perched on this glorious hilltop with breathtaking views. While on this lush green campus, we are all one big happy family, basking in the serenity of the big trees and the melodious birds taking shelter in their foliage. SALCC is nothing more than a collection of dilapidated and semi-modern buildings. Unfortunately situated on this barren hilltop, a place where you were surrounded by vicious, self-righteous people who were so eager to fight you down. We're on this grassy, jungle-like campus, a nine noisy blackbird so artistically decorated our favorite lunch table or kiosk with their generous droppings. Whatever it was, we were here. And after that intricate blend of pleasure and pain, which is life at Sir Arthur, we can derive peace in explaining those sweet, divine words, "It is finished." But what else? What of those pleasurable moments at Sir Arthur? Are they really over? Who can forget those long hours of constructive conversation in the kiosk, at the lunch tables, in empty classrooms? What of those rare occasions of joy which we forced ourselves to endure amidst the comforting powers of work which caressed us? Do you remember, my fellow graduates, those cold, dark rainy days when campus was enshrouded in a veil of mist? When visibility was poor, and we huddled together, purely for warmth, I assure you. What of that glorious day when our eyes were fixed on the halo around the sun? When some of us were content with natural explanation for this phenomenon, while others frantically claimed it a miracle? Were you fortunate enough to experience the tranquility induced by watching a sunset from campus, or by taking in the view from OTW? To those dedicated patrons among us who could always have been found in the vicinity of the cafeteria at whatever odd hour, your presence will be truly missed. We will remember the exciting inter-house competitions, especially the track and field events at the Mindo Philip Park, Let me assure you, my fellow graduates, no matter what distorted picture statistics may be, Walker House is indeed the number one house. We shall never forget those friendships which were established, especially those which blossomed beyond friendship. Whatever your decision, you make powerful, lifelong memories of Sir Arthur. By merit of being who you are, my fellow graduates, your departure has created a permanent void in this institution. Nothing will ever take your place. It takes the right amount of salt to effect a scrumptious dish, as we all know. And our brief time here was not without its sour moments. Far from nights of endless pleasure, were those sleepless, frustrating nights of last-minute study and competing assignments, those weekends which never came, and festivities foregone for the greater good of academic excellence. I had a night of the level even of the season that will take care of that. Then, there were those dedicated lecturers who treated the subject as though it were the only subject, and who indiscriminately furnished us with overburdening assignments at the expense of our other courses. There were those gloomy days of judgment when time stood still, when months of accumulating knowledge were summed up into minutes of agony and despair, a tragedy most commonly referred to as an exam. Some of us, better than others, will remember SALCC's lessons in humility. Lessons such as our endurance of leaking roofs, outdated equipment, and even mosquito-infested classrooms. It's true. Lessons, my fellow graduates, which continue to this very night. For have you taken the time to appreciate that we, graduates of the highest institution of learning on this island, are graduating in a parking lot? At the end, my fellow graduates, through our dedication and discipline, we were judged worthy to be here. But we remember our friends who fell along the way. As Phil Lane, our valedictorian of 2001, stated, anyone can pursue, but it takes the dedicated to persist. The dark vaults of Sir Arthur hold countless tales of friendships failure, of sweethearts separated, of time wasted. But our names will forever be engraved in its hallways of light, of hope, of excellence. We do not stand in the hallways of Sir Arthur alone, my fellow graduates, but are surrounded by those whose love, dedication, and service have brought us here. To our beloved parents who have invested so much in us in so many ways, who sit in the shadows while we, your children, shine, we say thank you. To our lecturers, whose knowledge and charisma have been imparted to us, whose company we have enjoyed and we miss dearly, we say thank you and we love you. To all academic, administrative, and ancillary staff who have given and those who continue to give of themselves, that this institution will forever remain in pursuit of excellence, we say thank you, we love you, goodbye. The myriads of challenges which confront us in everyday life provide fertile battleground for conquest. Conquest which will undoubtedly be facilitated by the skills which we have acquired during our brisk walk through this college. SALCC has placed us steps closer to our lives and ambitions, qualifications nearer to our desired careers. We are now in a strategic position, capable of transforming the agriculture, business, education, health, hospitality, and other diverse sectors of this, our peaceful St. Lucia society. Martin Luther King stated that peace is not merely the absence of war, but the presence of justice. Let us go out, agriculturists, businessmen and women, nurses, teachers, technicians, all of us, architects of society,